Hello everybody, welcome back to the Binding of Isaac, the Mega Bonus series. We're jumping in again in our last run. We unfortunately met a miserable end, as you can see, as Eden here. I'm jumping straight back in, back-to-back recording. Sometimes you just gotta go for it. Regular Lilith to Mega Satan. Ooh, regular Lilith could be kind of interesting. I don't really like regular Lilith, to be honest, but she could be kind of interesting, for... Do you know what? This is already a room where I'm gonna use this. Should be kind of interesting for, some of the new familiars that we have within within the mod pack that we're playing with, because there's going to be some custom familiars that will work with Box of Friends, and I think that could be really good. I'm pretty sure like all of them will work with Box of Friends, but I can't actually speak to that for sure. Do you know what? Already, you've done it to me, game. You've already done it to me. You've proven to me in a moment's notice why I don't like Lilith. Like, it's like, if you start as, like, Judas, you have the Book of Belial. The Book of Belial's heckin' good, but you don't need it as Judas. But you need the... That hit me? Okay. You need the Box of Friends. You absolutely need the Box of Friends. So it's kind of like, well, fuck you then, I guess. Thanks. Stop it, Eddie. Thank you. Right. Yeah, it's like non-negotiable with this character. Oh, for fuck's sake. I guess I'll take a Rotten Heart. This is gonna get mighty spicy. I'm not gonna go Downpour yet. I just do not have anything to help me work down there. And I have less health than I started with, so I don't want to go to a definitely harder floor. Good, good, good. I'm a bit scared. I'll admit, I'm a bit scared. I want to try and get a... I want to try and get a charge ready first. Ooh, yes. Free tinted rock. And, of course, it's a golden chest. Please reward me with a key for this room. Great. Okay. Let's go do this room. And we can pop this. Oh, you bastard! I'm going to die. Oh, I'm going to die. I swear Lilith is, like, the character that I die really early as the most by far. Like, I probably die in the early game as Lilith more often than I die in the early game as the Lost. Even the Tainted Lost. She's... Only having one red heart and two black hearts is already tough. Having her stupid firing mechanic is annoying. And then having to use Box of Friends for hard rooms is even worse. Should go and open this now. We've got a few keys. Very valuable. Big worth. This is a room I kind of want to use Box of Friends in, but that next room could be so much harder, so I'm not going to. Yeah, thank God we didn't. This was an easy room. Right. This is interesting. +5 bombs. Explosive enemies die on their own. Explosive enemies have the weakness effect. Nice, it's +5 bombs as well, I can get behind that. Okay, so explosive enemies dying on their own is going to be intriguing. In fact, this is probably a room we don't need to use our Box of Friends in either. It's a relatively chill room. Apart from that champion there, but nevertheless. It's also really hard to do the diagonal shooting tactic with the Lilith baby, the incubus. I will take this pill. Perks. Okay. We're good to go on you. We are good to go on you. I think you should actually be really, really easy. I'm looking forward to seeing how this premature detonation plays out throughout the course of the entire run. I think this could be a really useful item. Especially if you go to, like, the mines or something. I kind of need more health before I decide to go to the downpour, though. So this better didn't really pay out with what I wanted it to. Can't go to Devil Deals right now, either. I'm going to go to the shop, just because we do have bombs. We could blow up a donation machine, make a purchase. Hopefully, help our run out a little bit. Hopefully, we'll find something like adoption papers. That's kind of a nice catalyst for this character. We'll see. We got a good shop. Very good shop, indeed. Okay, so... I think we definitely bomb that, and we also bomb you. Oh, the donation machine needs to pay out guaranteed with more than that. We'll grab that as well. Prevents greed from spawning in a shop. Turns shop into a normal shop if greed was already fought. Okay, we'll keep that for if we fight a greed shop. Or we'll end up selling it down the river for something else. Am I okay with going to the downpour now? I don't know. I have to say, I'm gonna say no. I just, with a rotten heart as well, I just don't feel comfortable. I feel like we could easily die, and I'd like to keep my key for the item rooms there. Ooh, we actually got another one from the same pack as the detonation. The limestone carving. Rock spiders are friendly. Rock spiders misspawn when rocks are broken. Very intriguing. Whoa, this guy's looking awesome. So with the explosive detonation thing as well, and enemies like auto-detonating, we could get some interesting synergy with this limestone limestone carving. We could end up getting quite a lot of friendly rock spiders just by chance sort of thing. Yeah, thank you for finally destroying that one poop that had the fly in it. Really annoying me. Very tough room here. Luckily, he is destroying a few of the spiders himself. He's actually destroying all of them himself. I do wish I had my box of friends right now, but there you go. We managed it. Bob's curse. Okay, we are getting some interesting bomb synergies going on here. Very interesting indeed. We also got tarot cloth as well. I didn't really speak to tarot cloth earlier, but that's good too for us. Okay, so let's try and deal with the... I don't really know who to deal with first. I think the dumpies are the most annoying enemies, maybe, but kind of hard to say. How is that guy not dead yet? Okay, you're dead. You're dead. Good, good, good. Calm down, you dippy fuck. Dippy, dippy boy. Dippy, dippy boy. Okay, good. Let's keep it moving on. Okay, so one thing I'm noticing already is that right there is an explosive enemy. He did not detonate. Oh, wait, there you go. He instantly died, though. He only took one hit. He had that weakness effect. It's kind of a hard room here. Just don't get behind the dumpies. Still don't think we need to use Box of Friends here. The big room next to us is probably a better contender for that. We got good fire rate from Mr. Dolly as well, so that's another reason not to. Look at these cheeky shits. I'm trying to get them to dive into the spiked rocks, but it's kind of difficult to coerce them into doing that. You just got to kind of hope it happens more than anything. Good, we'll check in here. Stone chest, plausible. Yeah, this is definitely a doubling our familiar sort of room. This is a hard-ass room, this. It's not too bad. We can manage it. Oh my god, the knockback is so annoying. But it's definitely a more annoying room than anything else. God damn it. I'm going to try and blow up some rocks here, see if we can get some, yeah, there you go. Get some rock spider buddies. I don't know if they persist through rooms for us. That'd be really cool if they did. We'll find out, I guess. Just you left. Okay, so we got two spiders left, three spiders. They do persist through rooms. Whoa! Why are they going so... Why are they, like, hyper speed? What the fuck was that about? That, like, really distracted me. As you can see, though, Lilith, we're just having a hard time. Like, even with all the stuff we've got going on for ourselves right now, it's, like, still having a real hard time. Nickel's rather nice. Careful of these dudes. Are these... I can't tell if these are resprites or new enemies. I'm pretty sure they're resprites. Okay, they're just going to sit on top of that fire there. Intriguing. That is a tactic I would not employ myself. Sadly, not a great shop there either. Oh, the dodges. I don't know how I managed that. That was some dodges I can get behind. Okay. This guy is such a pain in the ass. Oh my god. He's got so much health. Okay. We are good to go. pop this. I'm going to pop a bomb on you as well, and of course it's going to miss. That's why, wouldn't it? At least pop up in the poison, you fool. Enemies that go underground are the worst. Hit you, but I did unfortunately get hit. Ooh, Angel Deal could save our life. It did indeed. Okay, well, while not the best thing we could look for within our Angel Deal, I'll definitely say gaining this much is going to be good. The HP there is just incredible. Also, all of our rock spiders have come with us. I'm going to use my hermit card now. We do have two items for sale, interestingly, but we do have Curse of the Blind. Not realize that upon entering the floor. Yeah, okay, so there's some weird, like, I don't know if it's a bug or what, but, like, the spiders just get, like, cracked out of their fucking mind as soon as they go to another room. It's hilarious. They start off so normal, and then it's like, next room, they're like, oh my god, cocaine? I've taken so much cocaine. Okay, we're looking for a key at this point. This is definitely a room where I want this. So these are the rooms, in my opinion, with dumpies that I do think are a little overtuned. Like, you gotta remember, dumpies are real fast and they push you around a lot. And there's four of them in a small room with spikes everywhere. It's like, seems a, like a little, just a little bullshit in my opinion. Like, it's so hard to not get hit by them, as evidenced by me getting hit. This room's much more reasonable because there's no other enemies. The spikes are only in two sides of the room, so you can kind of keep your distance. And they're only in the middle of those sides. Ow.
Two of one.
I have tarot cloth, excuse me. Why was that not doubled? Okay, we're probably about to get hit on our rotten heart here, so let's just be prepared for that to happen. Yeah, we're finding a lot of dumpy rooms at the minute. They're cool enemies. I do like them. I just think they're a bit too sporadic. And that's probably why they were removed from Repentance. Just because they're moving around at the speed of sound. Ooh, there you go. Touch by poop. Oh, look at the custom pins as well. The custom pins are beautiful. Okay, we lost one of our wisps, unfortunately, here. Good. I will take this pill because we're in kind of a slightly dire situation. Speed up's definitely going to be useful. This is a hard room, somewhat. The big boy here is a bit scary, definitely. I'm really trying to take out the big boy, but we've slightly been cornered here. Probably should have used my box of friends. I'm really just hoping we get another familiar, like, real soon. Because we're in a situation right now where our DPS really isn't enough. Oh, beast flies. Also really annoying. Yeah, I just wish they only farted, like, when you got near them, rather than just, like, randomly all the time. It'd make them way, way less annoying to deal with. That was bullshit. You basically telefragged me. You know it. Right, we finally got some keys. That's not the door. Finally got some keys, so that's good. I'm going to check this for a secret room. It's not. Okay. Let's go back to our item room over here. We can go buy one of the items from our shop as well. So we don't know what we're getting here, unfortunately. Okay, so this is an item that I from Ipecac that previously I didn't really like. Oh, toothpicks is really nice here. Previously, I didn't really like. Basically, if you hold down fire for long enough, it should play a brief sound. And then, okay, they have changed it. Good. So, originally, it used to play a very annoying sound. Now it seems like they've very much tweaked that sound. Yeah, it's not audible anymore, which is, I think, good. Yeah, so it's basically like a lemon mishap that happens after firing for about 3 seconds. I think it's pretty useful. For situations such as that there. My wisp just saved me there. Obviously, you've got to hold fire for quite a while before it activates. There definitely is an audio cue, it's just much fainter, but believe me, that is a positive. Before, it played it all the time, and it was loud, and it was annoying as shit. It's a much better item now. It's much more passive, rather than being always sort of there, annoying the hell out of you. So definitely props to the Ipecac team for changing that up. And I'm sure that my constant complaints were one of the big reasons that was changed. Ooh, Brainworm or Curved Horn. We got the Angelic Box. What the hell does the Angelic Box do? Chance to spawn an Angel item, chance to spawn 2 Soul Hearts, chance to spawn an item. Okay. Yes, Seraphim. Hell yes. We'll definitely take Curved Horn here, I think. Brainworm's good, but extra damage is far better. And this floor has changed this run. It's turned it around some. It's definitely turned it around some. I'm very happy. Definitely Curved Horn and Seraphim are like the big two gets from that floor. Whipped Cream is going to be interesting too. The extra shot speed definitely helps with that delay. But yeah, Seraphim's a huge get because it's a familiar that's going to be able to be duplicated. And it's also a very strong familiar. Wait, can you hear that little dripping sound effect? That means that the yellow creep, the piss is ready to go. Ooh, what the hell are these? Oh, these are the enemies with the weakness applied. The explosive enemies with weakness applied. Haven't really seen that working all too much recently on many enemies, but there you go. Yeah, it's a lot less annoying than it used to be, I'll say that for sure. Ooh, that's nice. Definitely take that. Definitely take that indeed. Good, good. Item room, what do you hold for me? Dunce cap. Ooh, baby, do you know what that's worth?
Judgment.
I don't really think we want to take dunce cap in this situation, do we? Seems like it'd be a bad idea, especially once we lose these wisps and we have no direct way of firing. I mean, Seraphim kind of is a direct way, but not really. I mean, maybe Wish Shot just doesn't work and it just gives us... it would just give us Spectral Tears. It doesn't give us like a tier rate up or anything like that. So yeah, maybe it's not really worth it. Anyways, let's go back and explore the rest of these rooms here. Oh, Angry Flies. Angry Boys. I like them enemies. They're cool. They are very angry. Like the Angry Fly item as an enemy. Oh, what the heck? Do you know... they need to change that attack. These little tar dudes can do that thing where they like pop up a tentacle out of the ground. But they do it so rarely and it has basically no tell. So it basically always hits you when it happens. It's very annoying. What we got in here? Good, good. Leaving piss everywhere as we go. Leaving piss everywhere as we go. Here's a great personal question for you all to answer in the comments. When was the last time you pissed the bed? How old were you? I'm sure we're going to get some lies. This shop seems far too common for how good it is. Far too common. I don't actually remember the last time. I used to have this really weird habit, and bear in mind, this was when I was, like, a lot younger, like under 10 years old. I used to have this really weird, like, habit of pissing the bed pretty much every single time we came back from a trip. Like, the night, the first night of sleeping back in my own bed after, like, going on holiday abroad or, like, going to a friend's house with my family, like, going away from home for a while, like, more than, like, a week or two, I'd always come back and just piss the bed straight away. I don't know what it was about, but strange quirk. Ooh, I've not seen the Sister Visery sprite yet. This thing looks amazing. Wow. Holy hell, this is a good resprite. God damn, that boss looks so much better. Also some extra HP there. Yeah, I think it was just like one of those weird quirks of like, I don't know, something about being away from home. I don't know how many people have gone on holiday a lot And obviously not recently because of COVID, but like, I'm relatively well traveled for my age, mainly because my family was quite big into like going on holiday abroad when I was younger. I've not been as much since I've been an adult because, you know, I have to pay for it now and that costs money. But like when I used to go with my parents, and obviously they'd pay for me because I was a child, we used to go a lot. I've been to Egypt 3 times. I've been to the Dominican Republic. I've been to Sri Lanka. I've been to Dubai very briefly. Tech L. Hell yes, I love Tech L. Literal laser sight. Yeah, I've been to Dubai very briefly. Basically, it was when I went to Sri Lanka, we did a changeover in Dubai. So I got like an hour in Dubai. And I can tell people I've been to Dubai. And then where else have I been? I've been to Spain a good few times. I've not been to America yet. I'd like to go to America. I have friends. I have family even in California. So is it California? I don't know. I have friends in America. Family in America even. My mum's cousin lives out there. So I'm probably gonna end up going and visiting there at some point. It would be pretty cool. My god. I love these lasers. Okay, so these guys are explosive. We got some rock spiders. There you go. I'm liking that combo there. Okay, one rock can spawn multiple spiders too, I'm noticing. And then they get cracked up on the next room. Maybe that's to make sure they die. Like, to make sure they actually hunt enemies. I don't know. Don't know what the cause of that is. But yeah, where has everyone else sort of been? Has anyone else like traveled a lot with their family, or like any of you that are old enough to travel on your own? Have you like been anywhere nice? Rainbow chest, hell yes. Like I said, I've been a few places and it's been real nice. Love that. Okay, we got ourselves the screw, that's awesome. That item here, coffee, can't stop, won't stop. That is, oh, proportional damage up to your movement. That's awesome. It's a really cool idea. I like it. Burn penny, 25% chance. Pick up. Okay, that's pretty good. But curved horn is curved horn, so can't take it. Item, midnight snack. Okay, we've definitely done some good there. Again, I absolutely love the fact that minimap API actually has specific minimap icons for like rainbow chests and stuff. So nice. Nice. Oh, we got some hot coals there as well. What the hell? I don't know where we got the coal enemies from. We don't need to go to anywhere else in this floor, do we? Okay, let's absolutely wreck this boss with our laser beams, with our eye vision. We are going to Mega Satan. I've not been paying attention to going to Mega Satan at all. I had opportunity to kill the statues, but I did not. We'll take the Polaroid then, I guess. We'll check this devil deal. And do you know what? I'm going whole hog here. Sinister sight, strike fear into something, and then Ouija board's unfortunately useless. I'm wondering what Sinister Sight does. I need to install the Encyclopedia mod because it allows you to like look up items. Would be nice to be able to know what certain things are doing. Goddamn, our shot speed is absurd. 5.10. My lord. Okay, definitely some homing. Sinister Sight is definitely giving us some homing, but I think due to our insane shot speed, it's definitely not performing as it should, or not being as strong as it should, maybe. Oh god, this is where I died last time on the wound because I took too much damage. So I need to be careful. Do we piss blood on this floor now, or is that just like the blood on the floor that's making it look like that? What? Who pushed you then? Who did that? Horse pill. Gotta have it. I can see forever. Okay, this is actually a good one. We can utilize this quite nicely. I can see forever. No thank you with those guys. Boom, boom, boom. We'll check in here as well. Okay, we got the Guppy Soul. Gives a Guppy Soul orbital that turns enemies' shots into blue flies. Okay, if this gets duplicated too, it's going to be rather nice. Still, health is looking not great. I always do this to myself. Yeah, the knockback is absurd. The knockback is just crazy. Okay, yeah, we're definitely getting some strong homing here, but the shot speed is kind of overtaking it somewhat. Hey, this is one of my secret rooms. Hello, fellas. I will indeed partake in you. Yeah, there's a card and credit card. All trap items are free if you pick up more than two items. I mean, we're not going to get anything, any use out of that. I think we'll take that to the next floor in case we need it. Just in case we need it. Goddamn, we are strong, though. We are strong now. The matriarch's going to be a problem, but we should be okay. The knockback and everything is just going to be so good for this. Go away, big fat chubber. Sadly, no longer drops 1,000 items when it dies. 1,000 hearts, even. Oh, yes. Beautiful. Beautiful. Right, let's go. Back on. Let's keep it going. Oh, for God's sake, these invisible enemies. Always get me. Just keep it going with this. We don't need our money for anything, so let's just roll the burn, see what we get. You can get soul hearts out of these rarely, so why not? Okay, we're out of ammo. Out of ammo, what am I about? Out of money. I always forget these can give you pretty flies. Right. I think it's the whipped cream plus the insane shot speed that's giving us like the damage that we have right now. Like that's why we're kind of wrecking through the game so quickly. Oh, also Cambion Conception gave us a demon baby. Not the best baby, but I shall take. To have and to hold. God damn, the homing's so funny. You just see the laser just try and like curl. It's like, nah, it ain't happening, buddy. This is too much speed for you. That should not have hit me. The shot speed's too high. I can't hit him. The shot speed, it's too much. Oh my god. I am messing this up. Hey, there you go, secret room. Hello. Forever. I need to be careful. My health is not great right now. Probably should have gone back and picked up some hearts, but there you go. I've got the sun card. I'm fine. That could be good. Or it could be terrible. Hey, this is another one of my secret rooms. We're getting lucky. We are getting lucky. I mean, this isn't a great one, but... it is one of mine, at least. I can't even destroy this poop look. Let's just create as many little rock dudes as we can. Oh my god. Oh! There you go. Oh my god. These are gonna go ham on the boss. This is amazing. Look at him go. Go, my buddies, go. Okay, we can't do hush. My god. My god. Look at him go. We should have been doing this more. Definitely don't want to give away our book. If they touch fire, they get set on fire. That's what's happening sometimes. Oh, I should not have been hit there. We're getting a lot of hot calls about. Damn it. Nothing from those? We don't get any on the next floor, so we need to make the most of this floor. I walked right into that fire. Again, got to be real careful here. I'm kind of messing this up. My god. This is hilarious. Just look at them go. They just cover the screen. Cover the screen. Just remember that we've got our sun card if we need it. We just created hot coals all over the entire room. It's hilarious. This is such a good combo. Whipped cream is saving our run. Okay. Things are about to get spicy on this next floor, but... We got the Book of Jubilees, that's quite good. Big Fang could be decent. The Knot, chance to whip enemies. Interesting. Oh, there's the whip. Oh my god. This is so dangerous. We're so close to death. Oh, Soul Heart, saving grace, thank you. These bad boys. Ooh, this Knot thing actually whips pretty reliably. Anything's in range, it's just popping off. I like it. Visually as well, it's pretty amazing. I've actually been talking to the person that makes the items from this, like the quarry items that we've got and the rotten collection items we've got. I've been sort of having a chat and giving them some ideas on little balance changes as well as like some ideas for future mods and stuff. Been pretty cool. I really love working with modders. I mean, you guys, any of you that watch my any of you that watch me play Enter the Gungeon will know how sort of involved I am within the modding scene of that. I help do a lot of testing for a lot of modders. I help with ideas for some people. I really like being involved in that side of things. It's fun. Soul Heart, please. Thank you. We also got a Holy Mantle from Book of Jubilees. You little fucker took my Holy Mantle, you stupid door mimic. God damn it. On this floor is where door mimics catch me out the most. This is like the floor that I'm least likely to look at the map on. Okay, get those whippies going. Nice. Get those whippies going. Not found any chests yet, unfortunately. Oh my god, the dumpies. Just why? Just why? They're so strong and faced. Too many of them in one room. Oh my god. This is going to be insane. This is going to be insane. That's a door mimic right there. I see you. And we got one of the best ones. Nice. Gotta say, I do kind of want the sun card, but... At the same time, a Cardian's Humanity on that room we were just in could be pretty valuable. I'm gonna take the Cardian's Humanity instead. Hopefully we get Petrified Poop pretty quick. We have already had Petrified Poop, though, so maybe it won't show up. Still, we've already gained a Soul Heart out of this. I think that's pretty good going. Just keep popping those poops. It's beautiful. I love doing this in a big room. Cardian's Humanity is so fun. And having rooms where we get to see the big poops more often is pretty cool, too. I very much like that. Okay, we managed to get a good amount of money. Sadly, only one soul heart so far. I was really hoping we'd get at least two or three out of this, just to make it a little more worthwhile of leaving the sun card behind. But it is what it is. It is what it is. We've at least got red hearts left behind to heal up as well. That's good. Still no chest. Okay, keep moving, and here's our boss. Good, good. I love the fact that these little dudes, these new worms, can replace the normal ones, because bosses like this can spawn them more often. Hey, there's a chest. Little chub. And we got a holy mantle before walking into. Little chubs get doubled too. Sadly, we didn't get any rocks, but there's no rocks in this floor, so that's fine. It's not like we could have got any. Our limestone babies. And you have been taken out, sir. Thank you. There you go. What a run. I hope you guys enjoyed that one. That was very fun. And I'll see you guys in the next one.